This video demonstrates the use of the corner flash GS108A flashing corners. This is a very common recessed flashing condition. We have a double 2x4 wall, we have a slight slope at the lower edge, and solid backing has been provided around all points of this recessed framing. We see this condition just about everywhere in California and the West. The first step in this procedure is to apply a bib across the lower edge of the recessed opening. This will allow for building paper to be tucked up under later. We're going to use moist stop sealant. This is a great polyurethane sealant that's been designed to work with all the moist stop products. Sealant is an important part of this assembly. It protects us from future razor knife cuts in these lower corners. You should apply sealant just as you see here. Okay, this is a GS108A. This procedure has been value engineered so that only a GS108A is used in this assembly. We've eliminated the B pieces in an effort to help people save money. It's important, though, if you're going to do this, that you understand the fold. The first step is to fold for depth, and then you fold, some people call it a pig's ear, at a 45-degree angle to achieve your inside corner. Fold it just like you see here. While this is a very simple fold, you are going to want to practice this a few times. Once you've got the fold correctly done, set your corner into place and secure it with staples. One of the nice benefits to this system is the nice tight corners that are achieved. Notice how tight that inside corner is. Now, in most framing conditions, the corner will extend into the opening a little bit, but that's no problem because it can be easily trimmed, as you see here. Now we're going to take care of the opposing corner using the same procedures as on the first corner. Sealant is applied, then the GS108A corner is folded correctly. First we fold for depth, then we fold the inside pig's ear at the 45-degree angle. The corner is opened up and set into place. It's pretty easy. Doesn't get any easier than that. So we're going to cover about 3.5?
3.5 plus 2.5, 6 plus 4.5, 10.5. Here, up here, 10.5.
Okay, what you just saw Percy do was establish the dimensions needed so that the FortiFlash will roll all the way onto our framing sill. He took those dimensions and made a mark up the wall to the point that we hold our FortiFlash. We apply the FortiFlash to the wall and we J-roller it to the substrate, as you see here. Now that our FortiFlash is correctly applied, we're going to apply vertical slices so that the FortiFlash will roll into our opening where it will terminate on our framing sill. It's important to use your fingertips and proceed slowly so that you avoid unnecessary wrinkles. Once the material is in place, you want to J-roller it, just as you see here. Two final vertical slices are applied, and the FortiFlash is folded onto our framing sill. And as always, J-roller the material to achieve nice compression under the substrate. Okay, good. Now we're going to counterflash the ends of our assembly with two square pieces of Fortiflash. Now that our sides are counterflashed, we're going to J-roller the material onto the substrate. And as you can see, this is really starting to look like a strong assembly. Areas that have historically leaked now are nicely flashed. We're going to apply sealant to the edges of our SAF just for that extra level of protection. We think this is important. And we always tool our sealant into place. Now we're going to flash our window. This lower course of flashing is very important. It's important primarily because it helps us protect our lower ledge from damage that occurs during the course of construction. Now we applied the side flashing. Notice we're using Moist Stop Next nylon flashing. And now we apply sealant to the back side of the window fin. We use a big fat half inch bead of sealant on the outside edge of the fin. This is how your rough opening should look just before the window is installed. Securely fasten your window into place. We like screws. Screw it every 12 inches on center. Then butter your sealant flat. We applied sealant on top of the nail fin after the window was set in place. This buttered sealant method of window installation eliminates the need for additional flashing products to be placed on top of the nail fin. This is now a time-proven, effective way to prevent water intrusion around windows. This is how your condition should look just before the top flashing materials are applied. Your top corners are applied exactly the same way they were applied on the lower surfaces and stapled into place. This is how your assembly should look just before the top flashing is applied. Now we're going to use Moist Up Next nylon flashing, and we're going to use this so that we can separate the peel and stick SAF membrane from the sealant that we applied on the top of the nail fin. If you apply your flashing just as you see here, you'll be providing very effective flashing that will eliminate future water intrusion problems around your recessed windows. In this demonstration, we used GS108 A flashing corners. If you have a deeper assembly, you can use GS112 flashing corners, which provide a 12-inch return. Thanks a lot.